welcome you all to my channel. If this is your first time of coming to my channel, thanks a lot. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. So in today's video, I'm going to make a simple video on how to cut belt trousers. Now, belt trousers is simply a combination of your fitted trousers and your flare, and I hope you'll be able to achieve that at the end of this video. Don't forget to join us on Facebook, T-Designs, on our Facebook page, T-Designs, and also on Instagram, T-Designs. All the details are going to be in the description box, and you can also visit our website where we have different fashion topics and also how to achieve that using illustration. So what are the basic measurements required? Our waist measurement, hip measurement, round lap, and our trouser length. So our waist measurement is 34 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 10. Our hip is 39 plus 2 divided by 4 plus 1, we have 11.25. Our round lap is 24. Now, note that we divided our round lap by 2 and not by 4. You have to divide your round lap by 2 and not by 4. So we have 24 divided by 2, we have 12 plus 2, we have 14. Our trouser length is 48 inches. Now, that's for the total trouser length. What you are going to do is you are going to deduct from your waistline to your knee length first to give you your fitted trousers. And you also take away from your knee length to your trouser length to give you where you are going to have your full flare. So my waist to my knee is 20 inches and my knee to my length is 28 inches. Now, because I'm going to add my sewing allowance to it, my waist to knee is 20 inches. You are going to determine if you want it to have a band or not. You are going to determine if you want it to have a band or not. So let's say we are going with the one that has a band. So we are going to deduct 2 inches for our band. We have 18. We deducted 2 inches for our band. We have 18. Now we are going to go ahead and add your sewing allowance to it. So I'm going to add 1 inch for my sewing allowance. I'll be using half each inch to attach it to the band, and I also use another half inch to attach it to the flare. So I will have 19 inches. And for my knee to my length, I have 28 inches. I'm going to go ahead and add my sewing allowance to it, which is 2 inches. So I will have 30 inches. It simply means that from our waist to knee, we have 20 inches, but we deducted 2 inches for the band to give us 18 inches, and we added our sewing allowance to it. I hope you understand that. So we are going to start first with our pattern drafting before we move straight to the fabric. And with me here, I have my pattern paper. Now, one thing about this pattern paper is it's about 60 inches long, and it comes in a bundle. So I recommend every one of you who are used to drafting pattern to use this pattern paper, because it comes in 60 inches long. So this pattern paper is available at our store, and don't forget to join us on training, both online training and physical training. So now let's move straight into the pattern challenge, which is where we have the fitted trousers. So we have 19 inches. I'll go ahead and mark my 19 inches. So once I'm done with that, I'll go in with my pattern master and connect up our trouser length. Now we are going to mark our basic measurement. Upper hip is 6 inches, waist to lower hip is 8 inches, waist to our knee length is 17 inches. Okay, so we just use it to indicate where we are going to mark. So I'll go ahead and connect, divide our hip measurement by 2. So for our hip, we have 11.25. We just go ahead and fold the tape measure this way, and we have 5 1/4. So we are going to place it this way. 11.25 indicates what you have. So once we are done with that, we will connect the lines together. to give us a box. So this is what we have. Now we are going to go ahead and mark our waist measurement. Our waist, we have 10. Divide the 10 into 2, we have 5. Now you place the 5 on this midline. Mark where you have your 5 and your 10 inches. Now the essence of dividing it to give you this box is to make sure that your trousers falls in the mid part of it. So you divide your 10 into 2, you have 5 here and you have 10. And of course, this is our hip line. This is our hip line. This is our upper hip. So on your hip line, you mark, divide your 11 inches by 2. You are going to have the same box because we use the hip measurement to get our box. So once you are done with that, you come down with 1 inch on your hip line. Come down with 1 inch on your hip line. This is going to help you to achieve your flap. So you connect it together. So I will label this line as my flap line. This flap line, you are going to mark your round lap on this flap line. So our round lap is 14 inches. We'll go ahead and mark 14. So this is what we have, 14. Now the lower part of our round lap, I will go ahead and mark 12. Just because I want it to have that pencil shape. So this is for our lower round lap. So we'll go in with our quartermaster and connect the two round laps together. This is what we have. Now we'll go in with our armhole curve and connect our round lap to our waistline. This is what we have. You can see it. Now this other part of our waist, we'll connect it to this hip line. So this is what we are going to have. This is what we are going to have. I will go ahead and cut this out. This is what it's going to look like. So we are going to label it as our front. Now the difference between the front and the back block. Pattern paper for the back block. I'm taking my front pattern paper. I'm going to go ahead and place it this way. Now the back is always longer than the front, but it is not towards the round lap area. You have the longer length at the upper part of your trousers. So I'll go ahead and tape this down. It simply means we are just going to like remark what we have at this point. So on your flap line, mark 1.5 inches. So it's going to be longer with 1.5 inches. You can use 1.5 or 2 inches. It depends on the back side of the person. So I've marked 1.5 inches. Round lap at this flap line, mark 3 inches at this flap line. So the essence of marking 3 inches is because of the back side. So this is what we have. We simply go ahead and extend all these lines to the back block. So this becomes the flap for the back block. We added 3 inches to this part. Now, as you move up, you are going to reduce the measurement. So we mark 3 inches on this flap line. We mark 3 inches. This is 3 inches. You reduce it. Let's say we mark 3, 2.5, 2. You just basically reduce it. So go in with our armhole curve to get our new flap line for the back block. So this becomes the flap line for the back block because we automatically reduced our measurement. So checking this above, make sure that this flap line gives you 3 inches. So while you are coming up, you can just take 3, 2.5, 2 inches and that's all. So on this upper part, we marked 1.5 inches longer, so we'll connect it to this other side of our pattern paper. So it's going to give you like a slant shape this way. So you can see that slant curve because we increased it only towards the flap area. Now, as you also come towards the round lap, you also reduce it. But make sure that the area around this flap line, you have 3 inches. So we have 3 inches. I will reduce it to 2.5, 2 inches, 1.5. So you just reduce it. Then you also go ahead and connect the lines together. So this is what the back block is going to look like. So the difference basically is just increasing the length at the flap line, also extending your flap and extend your measurements. But make sure that at this flap line you have like your 3 inches so that your trousers is not going to be tight. So this is what our back block looks like automatically. So I'll go ahead and cut this out, the lines. So this is what you have for the back block after tracing the lines, and for the front block, this is what we are going to have. So I'll go ahead and cut this out. So this is what our back block looks like, and this is what our front block looks like. So by the time you place it on each other, you can see the difference is just towards this flap area and also at the length. To be using this African print. African prints are available at our store, both in wholesale and in retail prices. So you can see how beautiful the African print is. But the first thing we are going to do to achieve our flare, we've gone ahead to fold our fabric in a triangular form this way. So you just fold it in a triangular form. So once you are done with that, our round lap is 24. So we are going to place our tape measure. This is just for one leg, right? That's what we want to cut out now. So we are going to place our tape measure where we are going to achieve 12 inches, because 25 divided by 2 is 12 inches and the fabric is folded into 2. So we are going to mark where we are going to have 12 inches, and this is where we have 12 inches. So place our tape measure this way. This is 15, so you mark 15. And then you go ahead and connect the curves together. So this curve, by the time you check it, you must have 12 inches so that it can fit into your round lap. So this is what we have. Now from this point, we are going to go ahead and mark our length. And from the knee to the down to the trouser length, we have 30 inches. So we'll mark 30 inches. So place our tape measure. Make sure we have 30 inches. You now connect the 30 inches together. Let me zoom it in. So you now connect the 30 inches together to give you this round we are going to have. You can see the flare effect. And so we are going to cut out another piece for this. I'm going to go ahead and fold my fabric in a triangular form. Now, fabrics are available at our store. You can see how beautiful this is. So we fold it in a triangular shape. Then I'm going to go ahead and place this piece on the other, on the one I folded, and just cut it out, because we want to achieve the same thing for the both pairs. This is what I'm going to have. I'll just go ahead and notch this part. The essence of notching it is just to help me know the midpoint of it. So we'll set this aside for the flare, so you can see how full it looks like. To fold my fabric into two, and place my back block. Now for the back block, we are going to have two pieces for the back block. So I'll go ahead and cut this out. But we are going to have, for the back block, we have two pieces. So we'll set this aside, our front block. Now the front block also, you have to have two pieces for the front block. So after cutting it out, you will also have two pieces for the front block. So we go ahead and set this aside, fold it into two, cut out the band. Now because we deducted 2 inches for the band, we are going to add 1 inch for our sewing allowance. So the wideness of the band is going to be 3 inches, and the length of the band is going to be equal to our waist measurement, which is 34 inches. So I'll go ahead and... So this is what we are going to have for the band. So at the end of it, you have your band, two pieces for your front block, two pieces for your back block, and you have your two pieces for your flare. So the first thing we are going to do now, for the pocket, I'm going to have 4 pieces for the pocket. So we are going to move to the sewing room, where I'm going to show you guys how to couple this up. The first thing we are going to do is, we are going to go ahead and, this is our front block, we are going to go ahead and mark 1.5 inches, because we want to achieve a slant pocket. Okay, so we are going to use 1.5. This is where we have 1.5. So for the length of the pocket, I'm going to use 7 inches. For the length, we are going to use 7 inches, and I marked 1.5. So I'm going to go in with 1 piece of my pocket, and I'm going to stitch it. I'm going to go in with, so for the back block, we are going to take our pocket and we are going to stitch it at the edge without leaving any 1.5 inches, because the 1.5 inches we left is for the front to be able to achieve that slant shape. And of course, your pocket length is still going to remain the same, which is 7 inches. So we'll go ahead and stitch this all the way. After that, we are going to go ahead and stitch this side. But note that when you are stitching it, you have to check your measurement. Okay, so you know how many inches you want to take. So our round lap is 24. 24 divided by 2, we have 12. And over here, we have 14. It simply means that we are going to take 1 inch on this part and 1 inch on the second side. So I'm going to mark 1 inch. And I'm going to stitch this 1 inch all the way to where my pocket starts from. You can see that slant effect at the pocket side. So this is the essence of the 1.5 inches we left. You can see having this slant shape at the pocket side. So once you are done, we are going to go ahead and close our pocket. Close this other part. So I'm going to go ahead and stitch 1 inch all the way down. We are going to fix in our darts at the back. So after, the reason why I love to do it after I fixed my pocket is so that I can get the midpoint. So we'll go ahead and fold the back block into two, and we are going to stitch our darts at the, but I'm going to make use of 4 inches so that we can just have the short darts. So mark 4 inches. So I'll go ahead and stitch it all the way in the trouser length, and it close it up to the end so that we can fix in our flare to this part of our trousers. So I'm going to go ahead and take one piece of the flare where we have this round part, and I'm going to stitch it round our round lap. I'm going to go ahead, and after stitching it at this round lap, you are going to go ahead and close up the flare by stitching it all the way down. So after stitching the flare, the next thing you are going to do is you are going to take the midpoint of one piece and the midpoint, that is where you have your flap, you are going to make sure that the two points meet each other this way. Then you go ahead and stitch it all the way round. And I went ahead to iron paper stay just to give it a form of structure. So I'm going to go ahead and stitch this band to the waistline all the way round. The next thing you have to do now is to go ahead and fix in either your elastic or your zip where you placed your band. So I'm going to go ahead and put this on and show you guys what it looks like. So this is what we have. You can see the bell effect, and you can see our fitted trousers at the top. So tell us what top you could rock with these bell trousers. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe. I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye.